Hey there, welcome. In today's video, I am going to be sharing with you my morning skincare routine. Several of you have been asking me to film this video, so I decided to do it today. In today's video, I am going to be sharing with you products that work for me. I do want to remind you that I am not an expert in skincare. I am simply going to share with you what I use from day to day. Anyhow, without any delays, let's jump into this video so that we can speak skincare. The first thing that I take every single morning is a cleanser. And the one that I have been wearing currently is the Peter Thomas Roth Clinical Skincare Irish Mud Purifying Cleansing Gel. And this claims to purify and decongest skin. It removes and dissolves pore clogging, oil, and impurities. And I do believe that it does help balance my skin out. For that reason, I have been gravitating towards this every single morning. It is a very nice cleanser. It foams very beautifully and it makes you feel very nice after you've used it. I don't think that it strips my skin terribly. It doesn't leave it hydrated by any means, but it doesn't strip any oils off of it. And it does leave my skin just very nice and clean. I do want to mention that this is not a product that I use when I am wearing makeup. This is simply my cleanser during morning time. The toner that I use from day to day is the Andalou Naturals Fruit Stem Cell Science 1000 Roses Floral Toner. And this is just a spray. It smells like roses. It's a very nice toner. I don't think it cleans my skin. I don't think it does anything extraordinary for it, but it does give me a hint of hydration. For that reason, usually when I'm done with my cleanser, I usually spray about 3 pumps of this on my face, and it is just a very great start for my skin. For serums, I do apply 2. The first one is an eye serum, and it is a Reviva's Firming Eye Serum. This is a very affordable serum, and I apply it every single day and every single night. Before I discovered the better moisturizers that I've been buying currently, this was just a necessary step for me. Now I can do with skipping it once in a while, but I still really enjoy this step. It's a very cooling serum. This is how the product looks like, and I simply apply about 1/2 pump on my fingers and then I spread it underneath my eyes. It has a very nice effect and it is a very cooling and great start for my under eyes. The second serum that I apply is the Andalou. Again, we're going back to the Andalou brand. It's a skincare brand that I've really learned to love. But again, the second serum is the Andalou Naturals Turmeric Plus Z Enlighten Serum. And this is a new serum that I've found in Vitacost. I have never tried this. I usually purchase a blue serum, but I decided to give this a try. I've been wanting to purchase a serum with vitamin C because I hear that it's great for your sunspots or for your marks that you have on your face. So because of that, I've been wanting a vitamin C product. They say that it's great for anti-aging as well. So I don't know, I've never tried one, but this is the first time and I've been wearing it and it is a very pleasant product. So far, I'm very pleased with it. For moisturizers, I do wear 2 different ones. So let me share them with you and let me explain my reasoning. The first moisturizer, just my favorite one out of the 2, is the Tatcha Water Cream. And this is just a very pricey cream, but it is very worth it and it is very good. When you apply this on your face, you don't feel oily and this quickly and immediately absorbs into your skin and it leaves your face perfectly hydrated. I usually apply this on special events or when I have a full day of work or when I know that I'm going to be wearing makeup for a long day. When I apply this, I have no need for any extra products that offer me hydration. So for that reason, when I have long days, I really enjoy applying this, especially because I do have dry areas that bother me when I don't apply a good moisturizer and I wear my makeup for extended periods of time. Again, this one is my favorite one of the 2 simply because it's very awesome when it comes to moisturizing, and when it comes to the feeling on your skin even, this is almost invisible. It literally feels like you're applying water on your face and then you just remove it with a towel. And again, it just leaves your face very nice and hydrated. My favorite, but again, very pricey. And because this one is very pricey, I'll wear this right here from time to time. And this is the Andalou Naturals 1000 Roses Beautiful Day Cream. This is also a very nice moisturizer. This is what I used to always wear before I discovered the Tatcha cream. It's worth about $20 at Vita Cost. You can also find this at Ulta for about $25 to $26. This is a very nice cream. I feel like the durability of it is about 8 hours. Because of that, when I work, I rather apply something like the Tatcha cream. When I'm home, just on an everyday, simple day, I do usually take and apply this. When I know I'm not gonna wear makeup for long periods of time, or when I know that I can get away with a little bit of an extra moisturizing feeling on my face, then I will apply this right here. It's a very nice product. However, on my dry areas, when it comes to about the 8 hour mark, I do start feeling the need of hydration. For that reason, I do like the Tatcha cream more. But for the price, this is a wonderful product. This is probably my husband's favorite moisturizer. And every time I place an order, I need to order about 3 of these because my grandma really enjoys this product as well. Again, when it comes to moisture, I feel like the Tatcha cream is more potent, but this is a very adorable, nice cream as well. It keeps you very hydrated, but of course, for a shorter period of time. When it comes to under eye moisturizers, the one that I just adore at the moment is the D.n.a. with Dr. Brandt Triple Peptidoid Eye Cream. And this is just a very nice product. When you wear this, you don't need eye patches, you don't need eye masks. This offers all the moisture that your under eyes need. I adore this product simply because it makes my concealer look better, it makes my makeup look better, and it doesn't make my eyes look crackly. If I apply this in the morning, I'm good up to nighttime. If I forget to wash my face because I don't have any makeup on, I'll be good the next day. This is just a very nice under eye cream. Of course, it has a very hefty price tag, but to me it is completely worth it simply because it makes my under eyes look very, very nice and hydrated. So because my lips are extremely dry every morning, I do try to apply a lip balm. And my go-to has been the Ultra Repair Lip Therapy by First Aid Beauty. This is one of the best lip treatments that I've applied on my lips. Usually regular just lip balms don't work for me. I do purchase a lot of organic ones because I like to feel my lips moisturized. If I don't, my lips just feel very uncomfortable and very dry. But when it comes to actually repairing my lips and products acting and doing good things for my lips, this is one of the ones that really does a good job repairing them, soothing them, and hydrating them. The lip mask that I wear at night is just my ultimate go-to. That's my punch when I need hydration. That's just the ultimate savior. But this, for an everyday basis, for an easy application, this is just a wonderful, wonderful lip balm. Last but not least, I do want to mention that on days where I am going to be out, or when I am not going to be home, days where my face is going to be exposed to the outdoors, I do go in with a sunscreen in addition to my moisturizer. And the sunscreen that I just been adoring lately is a Neutrogena Hydro Boost Water Gel Sunscreen Broad Spectrum SPF 50. I've never liked a sunscreen in my life, and then I discovered this. Of course, wearing nothing would be more uncomfortable, but this is as close as it's going to get when it comes to a sunscreen. I hate the oily feeling, the gritty feeling that sunscreens leave on your face, and this doesn't do that to me at all. It's a very nice product. I can put it underneath my makeup and I can live with it throughout the day. some products just suffocate me, I just want to remove them, but this one doesn't do that to me at all. You do feel like it's there, you feel a small layer of it, kind of like the layer of a primer, but variable, nothing like your typical sunscreens. Again, I've never found a sunscreen I feel comfortable with, and this is probably as close as it's ever going to get. We've come to the end of this video. Hopefully you found it helpful or interesting. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Leave your comments and requests down below, and I'll see you around next time. Have a beautiful day or a very wonderful night. Goodbye.